things like trendy topics, like the bottom of it.
Subscribers.
have to share it. If you don't share it, you're not going to get too many views. You can start out with maybe about 2 views because they'll get an email from YouTube saying, Really Random Rants posted a new video. But if they don't click on that, you don't get that person's views, and if they don't check their email, they don't see that email. So really what you have to do is share it on Facebook, Twitter, just tell your friends about the video, send them the link. If you don't start sharing it, it's not going to get anywhere.
Yeah, we didn't get anything at all until we started sharing stuff. Mm-hmm.
And so that leads to our next point, which is how we get our name out there. We just share it at everywhere we go. If we're talking about YouTube, one of our friends will be like, hey, we actually have a YouTube channel. It's Really Random Rants. We make videos every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday at 3:30 p.m. Well, of course, when we started out, it was every Monday through Friday at 5 a.m. And so,
So we usually hang out with each other on Thursdays, and so we had to film 5 episodes, which usually take, including prep time, that usually takes a good like 2 hours per episode. And so if that's 2 hours, so that would be 10 hours of time to be able to get what we need to get done. We just didn't have that amount of time at that point. And so we shortened it down, and now our episodes are a little bit higher quality, despite the lack of quality.
So, what's it like doing a YouTube channel or a podcast? I actually have gotten asked this question quite a few times, and I've done other people asking how hard it is it worth it, why do you keep making it? Well, the short answer is because it's fun to do.
Yeah,
it's a lot of fun.
What it's like doing? Well, it depends what your job is on the show. If you are the person just in the video, that's all you have to do.
It's pretty simple for us.
If you're filming, that's probably all you have to do. And if you're filming and doing it, you probably just have to hit the record button and sit down. But if you're doing the editing process, then it takes hours and hours. I edit our videos now. I spend about 4 hours a day on each video. Sometimes 4 hours just gets part of the video done. So it's a lot of work. So if you want to do your own podcast or video series, you need to make sure you have the time to do it and that you want to do it.
Right.
Because if you don't want to do it.
Yeah, but if you really are into what you're doing, then it's worth it to take the time to have videos edited.
And with podcasts, it seems like it would be slightly easier because of the fact that they're not editing the podcast. They just, it's a long, podcasts are usually a longer thing. So people expect that when they go to a podcast. When you're going to a YouTube video, you're expecting short doses of entertainment that you could easily click off of it and onto and still get the idea of what you're getting. So we have to keep it to like a maximum of like 10 minutes. When what we're doing takes like 20 minutes. And so the editing process is arduous. You really cut out everything other than what you need in order to get a shorter version of it.
So sometimes you like to change it up a little bit and speed up the video because that adds a little bit of comedy because you're seeing this normal paced video and then all of a sudden it goes from like 100% speed to like 500. So it like speeds by, but you can still hear the audio, so you're hearing everyone talk really fast.
I've watched more videos that are sped up, and Victoria's voice, especially since she's the female in the group, and her voice is higher, it's like up there. It's like you can barely understand what they're saying because...
both video quality of the content we're doing, as well as the video quality of the trip. Because when we started, we used a small camera for a few videos, but then switched to a webcam, which was
so bad. It was easier for us, but it wasn't really good quality images. So the camera quality is really important for when you're doing something like this, because people will enjoy it more if they can see it and not like really blurry.
Yeah, and then just this summer, we got a nice camera. It was a $500 camera. And it's been serving its purpose really, really well. We've been able to zoom in, but which we were surprised, like that's something you expect from a camera today, and the cameras that we had used before that didn't have that ability, so
it didn't have a view set up on,
so there you go. And it's amazing how like the little normal thing we were used to with a normal camera can become so drastically more important to you when you don't know when you haven't had that in all your other cameras.
It also allows the ability to have a tripod, which means either someone does not have to be holding the camera, or it also means that you, first of all, you have it sturdy the whole time. You don't have to have everyone getting in on the screen. If you have someone filming your videos for you, like you mentioned, the Zoom, they can just do that instead of you having to move the whole laptop to get to another person's view, which, first of all, is a little bit awkward to do when you're in the middle of something, and second of all, it looks really weird because it's like, all right, you take the laptop so that you can talk for the next 5 minutes.
Like, see, the laptop, like, the lens is up here, and so when you're moving it, you move it like this a little bit, and the lens goes from here all the way to here, and so the angle changes completely if you move it at all. And so the quality was awful in those original videos.
We also, when we didn't have a webcam, we had a really bad camera. We didn't have a microphone at the time.
It
picked up barely anything. Like, occasionally, you'll hear what it is, but YouTube has a nice feature, which is closed captioning, which you can turn on. Problem is, if you don't add the closed captioning yourself,
it's on forever.
It will just try to pick up whatever you said. So it could be something totally off. You could be saying, oh, it's a really nice day today, and it will say, I really like strawberries.
You could get something.
Well, that happens to us when you try to be like, oh, whatever it's like with our closed captioning on. And then put it on, and then it's like totally off from what we actually
see. We've actually had to turn off closed captioning for a couple of the videos because it translates what we're saying as curse words.
Yeah.
So it takes like, oh, like you said, like, oh, it's a nice day today to like something you have to censor or it to be on YouTube.
As soon as we got the microphone though, because it had the audio picking up, it guessed most of it,
you know,
right?
So you can talk in a normal tone, quiet tone, you don't have to worry about the camera picking up what we're saying. But usually we even then we still have our voices a little bit up because it gives a better quality video, a better quality audio if you have your voice a little bit higher, louder.
So we talked about this a little bit, but we're going to go more in depth. Maybe you then. Why haven't you given up? And why don't you plan on giving up?
Well, because
despite our goals, frankly.
Well, we love doing this. It's fun, and now that we have viewers, they enjoy it. And so now we're doing it, but before we always liked doing it for ourselves because it was fun, and we didn't have too many subscribers or anything. We're like, of course we want to, so, but now that we have viewers, we're doing it for them, mainly for the people watching, because they're the ones going to see it. Because we most likely aren't going to go back and watch our videos a whole bunch of times. Like,
my grandchildren are not going to watch videos ever happen.
But yeah, so we aren't giving up because people like you guys who watch us.
It's also given us the freedom. It sometimes needs to motivate us for doing something that we really would not want to do. And then after we watch it, we're like, oh, actually that wasn't too bad. So things like Al putting duct tape over his arm.
I'm doing it. Here's the thing though, you have to keep it on the server to be
and then
so
next.
But yeah, again, going back to how much time it takes, it really depends on what job and position you're doing with it.
Correct. So like when you're actually filming it, the whole concept and the creative process, basically the actual filming and refilms, usually it takes like a good hour, 2 hours to get an episode done. But when you're filming some of the bigger episodes, like our live streams, sometimes take up to like 5 hours, and so you have to work that into your schedule because that's just an average time for a live stream. A good long live stream.
Yeah. And the other thing is, you want to have fun all the way. You want to do things you enjoy doing because if you don't, then you're going to want to give up if people are watching it. You're like, well, people are still watching it, but I don't enjoy doing it. No. Make sure you start out with something you enjoy because if you start out with something you don't just get viewers, then you're going to be stuck doing the things you don't enjoy for your viewers.
Yeah.
Make sure you're having fun with it. And people love to watch people having fun. The idea when you're happy and doing what you love.
It's more enjoyable to watch a person who's doing something they enjoy doing because they feel that you're more to excel and they're feeling more natural than watching someone who do something that they feel completely uncomfortable doing because then they get a little off and it's a little bit less natural.
Yeah, now we're going to take a few minutes for a question and answer period. So,
what
are you doing? No, we have to keep it on a little bit
longer. Which is alright. Now I come on.
Content are you planning on doing in the future?
Well, recently we've introduced lip sync videos, so we're planning on doing more of those. We're also thinking about doing introducing gaming soon. We haven't fully decided what type of gaming it will be, but we're planning on introducing that soon. So it might just be a mixed variety of types of games. Like it could be a game where you're fighting in one game and then suddenly it's a My Little Pony game, even though we won't do that.
There's a question that people have had on our social media about something we do in our videos. We do this hashtag definite first, spread it around. Hashtag definite first, it started in a really, really unconventional way. Victoria.
Okay, so we were all at our church as youth group. We were hanging out and stuff, and then this lady, Deb, she was in charge of everything. She was talking about how she had her
very likely that they're contacting us about hashtag that did it first. And so, since we're filming this, we might as well answer it on camera.
Oh, so another thing, going back to the media that's at some point on our content.
Attention, will all RockCon, all Pennsylvania Comic-Con staff and volunteers please go to the VIP area?
Yeah, we had to describe everything. That was a blindfold taste test. So we had him and
And then also the vanilla Rolos, the game Rolos. I hate Rolos.
I should be wrong.
I don't like Rolos because the back they roll.
The bags are quick to find out. He can figure out what the rock was.
He thought it was a furry bush.
Wipe it around. Get it all over.
You're not coming on the show.
Oh. Fair enough.
Just say that for him before.
Any other questions?
That just gives her more of a chance to get on the show.
No, you can come with a black face.
What's the flavor in the
pie? Apple. Yeah. Hey, what was the most beach? My face goes in. No. It doesn't go in my face.
Oh, your mouth is on your face. Any other questions?
Will Benny ever return to the show?
Not Benny.
What?
Benny the sock puppet?
Not Benny. Why don't you do some improv for us now?
Okay.
I was just kidding.
Give us a topic, a place, and a person.
Oh, I'm just showing you this.
Becky! Yes,
Becky.
You know what? You want to bar. We're at the bar at Becky.
The bar at
Becky. Alfred has a
comedic character.
Alfred. And the Joker is drinking away his sadness. Improv, everybody.
Don't have the face that I see.
make it so that you can make it to the extension on the back of it so that you can they have a beer hanging on a wall. That sounds awful. Oh gosh. So yeah, what do you say?
That's dangerous.
Yeah, that's a bad idea to go over here, yes.
Reminds me of that SNL skit. You ever seen that one?
No.
The guy is...
Don't finish other shows.
It's an old SNL skit. Dan Aykroyd has to sell, like, he's the manufacturer for, like, this big toy company. They sell, like, things like bag of glass.
So, Victoria is going to sing a song. It just has to be the chorus, and Al is going to lip sync to it.
Okay, I'm going to sing a song. Hit me, baby, one more time. That's the only part of the song.
I believe I can fly.
Whatever you say, it's not gonna cut it. It was ice cream. It was free ice cream.
Go ahead.
I can't.
Do it,
baby.
Do it.
So let's just panel off. Yes, going to the next number one says. Hashtag that did it first, and I had a really, really random day. Take it away, Alex!
Oh my God, oh